Hallelujah, dearly beloved. It's a beautiful morning. It's a new week, and we thank God for His mercies and His grace. I am Stephen Aite, your friend in faith, and I bring you a word from the throne of grace. The word of the Lord comes from Luke, the 8th chapter, and the 25th verse. And He said unto them, Where is your faith? And they, being afraid, wondered, saying one to another, What manner of man is this? For he commandeth even the winds and the water, and they obey him. The narrative tells us a story where Jesus has instructed the disciples to cross the lake to the other side. And while he's on the journey, he takes a nap. And in the midst of his napping, the Bible says, the winds pick up and the storms arise and the water begins to enter the boat and they feel threatened and they are scared. And the Bible says when they wake him up, he speaks to the wind. He ignores the water. He rebukes the wind and the wind ceases and the raging water calms down and everything else is restored to normal. And he asked them this pointed question, where is your faith? The question I ask you this morning is that, where is your faith? The suggestion of where, it speaks to the fact that in what have you deposited your faith? Where is your confidence? In what kind of thing is your faith deposited? Is your faith secure? Is your faith in your possession? Is your faith deposited in something around you, material thing, in your friends, in your wealth, in your health, in your ability, in your intellect? Where is your faith? Because your faith determines how far you can make it in this life. The Bible makes me understand that it takes little faith to go to heaven, but it takes great faith for us to have heaven come to us. The size of a man does not matter so much as the size of his faith. For men come in sizes, but it is the size of faith in a man that makes a difference. Every man is giving a seed of faith. Jesus said, if you have seed faith the size of a mustard seed, you can speak to mountains, which are problems, and they will disappear. We are also told that we can ask the Lord to increase our faith, which means that men have a measure of faith and he can plead for an increase, a double portion if you like. Then there is a gift of faith that comes by the Spirit, enabling you to accomplish great things. You must begin to personalize your faith, for he says to them, where is your faith? I ask you this morning, where is your faith? How and in what condition is your faith this morning? In what have you deposited? In what have you trusted? Bible says in Hebrews 11, and one that faith is a confidence and it's a conviction in things that we hope for and an evidence in things we cannot see. And we are told in the verse 6 of the same Hebrews 11 that faith is what we need to please God, because he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him and them that come to him knowing that he exists. So we need faith, and faith does not work in a vacuum. Faith will work with your works and work with love to bring you maximum delivery and to bring you what you desire in the Lord. Some call faith the currency of the Spirit, because it is that which allows you to acquire the things you require or the things you need. The Bible says the just shall live by his faith. I ask you this morning again, in life situations, when you are faced with life storms, is your faith in the Lord you call your God, or is your faith in the current realities you face? Are you looking at the storm, or you are looking at the one who is able? For I know, for in my own case, that I do not know tomorrow, but I know who holds tomorrow, and my confidence is that the one who holds tomorrow is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all I could ask or think. Hear me and hear me well, beloved. Evil winds may blow, situations may turn around, waters may enter your boats, problems may come against you, but you must have confidence in the Lord your God and strengthen yourself in your faith, that your faith will not fail. In Luke chapter number 22, verse 31 and 32, Jesus turns to Simon and says, the devil has sought permission to sift you like wheat, but I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail. I believe then that the antidote and the panacea to failing faith is a consistent prayer life. It is a connection to the source of your faith. The Bible says we must look up unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. And in that instance, then we must begin to understand that we cannot be disconnected from him and walk in faith. It is faith that will bring you the results you desire. It is faith that will bring you the health, the wealth, the blessings, the light, the peace. It is faith that will bring you the greater grace, the enabling power to walk upon this earth in dominion and in great triumph. I pray for you this morning that you shall be a praying man connected to the seat of grace, connected to the altar of faith, that as he imparts his faith and infuses you with greater grace, the seed of your faith will grow, the measure of your faith will increase, and the gift of faith faith will be imparted. I pray for you this morning that by faith you shall overcome adversity. By faith you shall triumph. And in faith in the one who is able, your faith will be great and wonderful in him. Shalom, my name is Stephen Aite. I came your way this morning again with a word from the throne of grace. And forever I remain your friend in faith. Till next time, beloved. God bless you. Bye-bye. You are the joy of the whole world.